this song of old from angels bending the earth to touch their harps of gold. Peace on the earth, goodwill to men from heaven's all gracious King. The world in solemn stillness lay to hear the angels sing. Still through the cloven skies they come with peaceful wings unfurled, and still their heavenly music floats through all the weary world. And man at war with man hears not the love song which they bring. Oh, hush the noise and cease the strife and hear the angels sing. Glory to God in the highest, glory to God evermore. Good news, great joy for all. Melody breaks through the silence.
Christmas season is in full swing. The marketing apparatus of Christmas has kicked in full. With Black Friday and Cyber Monday, it is now in full swing. And everything we're hearing is that even in the midst of a pandemic and an economic hard times for many people, there is more shopping going on online than ever before, just breaking all kinds of records. And yet, in the midst of that, we enter into this humble season called Advent. Advent is one of those things that we maybe have heard the word, but don't always necessarily know what it's all about. And I think if we're going to try to boil down what Advent is, it is really just simply the story or the time when we begin to really focus in on this idea of God's amazing breaking into human history in the form of taking on human flesh. It is an amazing thing that when you compare that with all the marketing and hype of Christmas season in our world today, all of that pretty much falls real short of all of those when compared to what this Christmas season is about in Advent, with this idea of God breaking into human history. And it is with this birth of the babe that God gives us a whole new understanding, a whole new reality about life and about its meaning. You know, we are going to be doing Alpha in January, and that's kind of the key of what Alpha is about, is what is the meaning of life? Well, we can boil it down and say, you know what? The meaning of life is about the birth of Christ, God becoming human. And I think that changes everything. Because in the birth of Christ, it marks this new dawning of light and truth and about who God is and who we are as his people in his creation. And so it is a step for us to say, you know what? In the midst of all of this craziness that we're experiencing right now in the world, we can understand completely and wholly that God is with us. God is our Emmanuel. To that end, I want to read some selected verses from Psalm 27 as a way for us just to prepare for embracing the fullness of Advent. It says, "The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is my stronghold of my life, and of whom shall I be afraid? One thing I ask of the Lord that I will seek after, to live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. For he will hide me in his shelter in the day of trouble. He will conceal me under the cover of his tent. He will set me high on the rock. Hear, O Lord, when I cry aloud. Be gracious to me and answer me. Come, my heart says, seek his face. Your face, Lord, do I seek. Do not hide your face from me. Teach me your way, O Lord, and lead me on a level path because of my enemies. I believe that I shall see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord. Be strong. Let your heart take courage. Wait for the Lord." This is our call, to be ready, to be watching, to ready to receive our King, to embrace him and to live fully into him in the new life that he offers us. So as we enjoy the Christmas season, let us remember it's not just about the marketing and the gifts and all of those things that are very much a part of our season, but it finds its root, it finds its source in Jesus. God stepping into history definitively, purposefully for you and for me. Let me pray for us. God, thanks for your willingness to do what we could not do ourselves, which is to save ourselves from our sins. Lord, as we enter into this Advent, this Christmas season, I ask that we would once again be awestruck by your action, by your coming to earth and taking on flesh, to live as we live, to experience the things that we experience, to be tempted the ways that we have been tempted, and yet not sin, and then go to the next step and offer yourself up, as a sacrifice for our sins. Lord, we are humble. And so as the psalmist says, we want to seek your face. So in this Advent season, Lord, let us seek your face. I ask that in your name. Amen. Well, hopefully you've heard by now some of the changes for worship as we transition back into the sanctuary. The most important thing is if you are attending worship on Sundays with us, a couple things will change. We will have in-person worship next Sunday, which is the 2nd, I think, of December. Maybe it's a little later, but it's that first Sunday in December. And then the next two Sundays, which are the 13th and the 20th, we will not have in-person worship. It'll be streaming only. All of our services will continue to stream all the time on Sunday mornings, as well as evening in December on the 13th at 4. That will be streaming only as well. Our plan is to invite everyone back in for in-person worship on Christmas Eve at 4 p.m. And so that will be our next time after this upcoming Sunday for in-person worship. And so just put those on your calendar and let you know that those are going on, and we will continue to connect streaming as well. One of the other things I want us to do is, I put it out, I think, maybe a week or so ago. I'd love to hear your stories of how you are living faithfully into our new life in Christ. The idea of sharing the love of Christ around you, perhaps even sharing the hope of Christ. Let me know your stories, and I'm looking for not big sensational stories, I'm looking for very ordinary, average stories. Things like just saying, you know, I saw this and I wanted to pray for them, so I just prayed silently. That would be good. I would love to hear those kind of stories. So if you want to send them to me or contact me, I would love to sit down and talk with you about those. So if you could do that, that would be much appreciated as well. As I mentioned earlier, Alpha is coming in January. And this is an opportunity for us, as we've built relationships with people who Christ misses most, to invite them to join Alpha. Perhaps you would join with them as a friend, to walk alongside of them, to just experience what it means to take some time to think about what Alpha calls the big questions of life. And so I invite you to think about who you might invite, and even get ready to start inviting them as we move into the Christmas season. Maybe it's even over Zoom or phone calls, because we're not maybe together as much as in the past. Take that opportunity just to invite. I would invite you to do that and see how God uses that and uses you as an instrument to bring His peace to this world. I hope you have a good day. God bless. Bye-bye now.
You're the love song. You're the love song. You so love the world. You're the love song. You came upon the midnight clear, that glorious song of old. Touch their hearts.